Bronzeville tonight will address concerns about the dozens of women found strangled to death or missing from Chicago's South and West Sides. Community members fear it's the work of a serial killer, and they're calling for action. WGN's Gaynor Hall has the story.
Give me a hug. How you doing today? All right.
Brenda Stewart works with the Dreamcatcher Foundation, fighting to end human trafficking in Chicago.
I feel like people don't care about women that are on drugs. They don't care about women that work the streets. I mean, they're human.
She says the unsolved cases of mostly black women strangled on the city's south and west sides are scary.
If a family member don't come and push the issue, of course they're not gonna look. You know, that's just another dead body. Let's take her to the morgue. She worked the streets.
Too many unsolved murders of strikingly similar type. Women who were disproportionately sex workers or drug addicts or both, who whose bodies were recovered out of doors in very specific places in a pattern quite indicative of serial murder.
Thomas Hargrove's Murder Accountability Project used a computer algorithm to identify a cluster of 51 homicides from 2001 to 2018. The most recent was Rio Renee Holyfield, whose body was found in a garbage can in September of last year. Hargrove says the murders could be the work of two or three killers.
DNA is critical, and the Chicago police are very carefully going over what evidence still exists and what can still be sent to the lab.
Stewart says something must be done.
And I love you.
It's just a scary feeling. You know, I educate all the ladies. I make them aware of, you know, I ask them to watch each other's backs. And right now, it's just basically these ladies against the world.
Hargrove and Stewart will both speak at tonight's community meeting hosted by Congressman Bobb Rush. Rush has sent a letter asking the FBI to get involved in processing the backlogged evidence related to these unsolved cases. Reporting tonight from Bronzeville, Gaynor Hall, WGN News.